Hello everyone, welcome to Sun Educare. This video is for solving MCQ problems in GST. So in this video, I will be solving 10 MCQ from our institute material. So you can download the material from our institute website and let's start. So we will be solving 10 problems per day, so that it will be useful for you to revise also. Okay, so yes. So X & Co, a registered supplier of Meghalaya, wants to opt for composition levy. The turnover limit for composition levy is, let us recap the provision of composition levy once before solving the problem. So I'll show you a notes where you can find the composition levy note, related notes. Okay, so composition levy section 10 for goods. So first of all, if a person wants to opt for composition levy, he has to deal with goods and his turnover should be less than or equal to 1.5 crore. But in case of special category state, the aggregate turnover of a previous year should be less than or equal to 75 lakh. With respect to the meaning of special category state, the following states are covered: Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Nagaland, Manipur, Sikkim, Tripura, Uttarakhand, Meghalaya. So first of all, we should check whether the state falls under the special category state. In the given question, the XY & Co is a registered supplier of Meghalaya. So Meghalaya is covered under special category state. Special category state. So for special category state, the limit is 75 lakhs. So the answer is 75 lakhs. Okay. So next question. The person making interstate supply from Madhya Pradesh is compulsorily required to get registered under GST. So for this question, we have to look into the provision of registration. Okay, so let me show you the provisions. Okay, so in case of registration, so this is section 22, they are discussing that every supplier who is liable to get himself registered if his aggregate turnover exceed 20 lakh. And in case of special category state, it is 10 lakh. But the question is not about that. In the question, they have state that the person is making interstate supply. You have to please underline the word interstate supply. So this interstate supply is covered under section 24. 24 deals with mandatory registration, which means every person who makes interstate taxable supply have to mandatorily get themselves registered irrespective of turnover. So in the given case, the person has to register irrespective of his turnover. So the best suited answer is D, in case of making interstate supply of taxable goods, irrespective of the amount of aggregate turnover in a financial year, the person has to get himself registered. Fine. We'll move to third question. Which of the following services are exempt from under GST? So agriculture produce, farm labor, warehousing of agriculture produce. See, basically for agriculture produce, whatever we are dealing with, when we are dealing with agriculture or agricultural produce or farm labor, everything will be covered under exemption list. Okay. So I think we don't have to check for the provision. You can directly go for all the above if all the options are dealing with agricultural goods. In the given case, testing of agriculture produce relates to agriculture. Supply of farm labor is also relating to agriculture. Warehousing of agriculture produce is also relating to agriculture. So you can directly go for all of the above option. In the given case, the answer is D. Okay. So we'll have a quick recap of whatever we have seen from the beginning of the video. In the first question, the summary of the provision is, in case if a supplier is from special category state, he can opt for composition levy if his turnover limit is less than 75 lakh, less than or equal to. The crisp of second question is, if a person is making any interstate supply, he has to get himself registered under GST irrespective of the turnover. Next, in the crisp of third question is, whenever you are making any agricultural supply or you are dealing with agriculture goods, it is totally exempt under GST. Fine. We'll move to fourth question. Mr. Narayanan Goyal has booked a room on rent in Sunshine Hotel for purpose of lodging on 10th August. GST is not payable by Mr. Narayan if the case of value. This is a straight provision. If the amount, the booking amount, if it doesn't exceed 800, we don't want to get ourselves registered. Otherwise, we don't have to pay any GST. Otherwise, we have to pay GST. Fine. So, input tax credit is not available in respect of. So, input tax credit, when we look it into the answer, service on which tax has been paid under composition levy. So, we'll check the provision of composition levy once before. So, in case of composition levy, if a person is, we have to check the turnover limit. If the turnover is less than 1.5 crore or 75 lakh in case of special category state, he can opt for composition levy subject to few other conditions. The conditions are the person should be engaged in goods which are leviable to tax, and he should supply only goods. He can supply service which is related to food industry, and he should not make any interstate outward supply. Within the state only he has to supply, and he should not be engaged in supply of goods through electronic commerce operator. So if he satisfy all the above conditions, he can opt composition levy, and he and as a result of it, there is no need to collect tax. When he is not collecting any tax from his customer, obviously he should not avail any ITC, right? So that is the provision is all about. So the answer is yes, ITC is not available in respect of composition levy. And in case of free samples and personal consumption also, we cannot take ITC because free sample is not a supply, and personal consumption obviously we cannot take because we are using it for personal purpose. So we cannot take ITC for the same. So answer is D. Next question. Shubhas and Co, a registered person supplying taxable goods to unregistered person, it need not to issue invoice. See, this provision is all about doesn't have to issue any tax invoice. When two conditions are satisfied, there is no need to issue tax invoice. Condition number one, if the recipient doesn't require any tax invoices. If recipient is not requiring any invoices, obviously we don't have to give any tax. So next point is, if the value of the goods is less than 200, if the value of the goods is less than 200, we don't have to raise any invoice. So answer is 200. Next, service of transportation of goods by dash are exempt from GST. Service of goods, in this question there is a small mistake in the options given below. In the option, you have to strike this one. The answer is 2 actually. Answer is 1. Service by way of, service of transportation of goods by way of road are exempt from GST. So the suitable option is except 3, 4 and 2. So they have indirectly given the option, but there is a mistake in the option given below. In the answer sheet, they have given that except 3, 4 and 2. But in the question page alone, they have given the option wrongly. So just make appropriate changes. Next question, transportation of dash by rail from Chennai to Gujarat are exempt. Pulses are related to agriculture goods, so obviously it is exempt from GST. And for military equipment, we don't have to pay any GST, and so the answer is 1 and 2. But for electric equipments and all, we have to pay GST. So the appropriate answer is 1 and 2. Service, next question, service by way of warehousing of dash is exempt from GST. So when we are having the following goods, there is no need to pay GST when we are warehousing these goods. So the goods are tea and betel leaves. Tea, jaggery and betel leaves. These three goods are dealing with agriculture goods. So for these three, we don't have to pay GST if a person is providing service by way of warehousing of these three goods. So answer is D. Okay, next question. GST is not payable by recipient of service in the following cases. So when the recipient of service will pay the tax, when the service are covered by reverse charge mechanism, instead of supplier, recipient will pay the tax. So in the below four circumstances, in some few circumstances, the GST is not payable by recipient, which means they are covered under forward charge instead of reverse charge. So we have to find out which are covered under reverse charge and which are covered under forward charge. So this is one of an important and a confusing question. Okay, fine. So first subdivision, service provided by way of sponsorship to ABC Limited. So we look into the provision related to sponsorship service. In case of sponsorship service, the recipient should be a body corporate or a partnership firm, which means if a recipient of a service is a body corporate or a partnership firm, then it will be covered in reverse charge. In the given option, services provided by way of sponsorship to ABC Limited. So the ABC Limited is a body corporate, so it is covered under reverse charge. So this is reverse charge, RC. Okay. Second point, service supplied by a director of Galaxy Limited to Mr. Krishna. So we have to look into the provision related to directors. Okay. So the supplier should be a director and a recipient should be a company or a body corporate. See, in the given case, the service is supplied by a director. So the supplier is a director, but the recipient is Mr. Krishna. He is an individual. But if the provision related to reverse charge says that the recipient should be a body corporate or a company, only then it will be covered under reverse charge. Otherwise, it is covered under forward charge. So in this case, it is a forward charge. Third question. Service provided by Department of Post by way of Speed Post to MNO Limited. So these are the provisions which are covered by services provided by central government or state government or union territories or local authority. So in this provision, they have said that the recipient can be any business entity located in taxable territory, but it is not applicable to service by department by way of speed post. So speed post is specifically covered in the not applicable list. So obviously this will be covered under forward charge. And the last one, service by a recovering agent to SNSP bank. So we have to look into the provision related to the bank and the recovery agent. The supplier should be a recovery agent and the recipient should be a banking company or financial institution or non-banking financial institution, then it will be covered under reverse charge. So in the given case, the supplier is a recovering agent and the recipient is a bank, so it is covered under reverse charge. So the question is all about in which of the following cases the GST is not payable by recipient of the service, which is not payable, which means they are asking which of the following are covered under forward charge mechanism. So the option is, answer is 2 and 3. So answer C. So that's it. So thank you guys. If you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe to Sharnajikya. Thank you.